Hey guys, how's it going? Heath here from the Heath and Kendi Vape Variety Show. I want to say good day to our Facebook viewers and good day to our YouTube viewers. As you can see, Kendi is not with us tonight at all. So hopefully, you know, I can make up for the both of us. Tonight's show, we've got a little bit of news. We're doing a bit of a follow-up, especially on that 18-year-old kid that had the lung collapse. And a bit of other news. The details have actually come out a little bit as that Australian study that was supposed to be done into vaping in general that Labor have pushed so hard for. Also tonight we're going to be looking at, what are we going to be looking at? We're going to be looking at a couple of juices that I picked up on my travels whilst I've been doing a bit of work down at Geelong Vape Co. on Saturdays. And we're going to be looking at Mystery Shop. Just double checking, and it looks like Discord isn't working again. How fantastic. Okay. G'day. Peeps, how's it going? I hope everyone's doing well. We sort of just, as I said, I'm jumping around again because, once again, as I probably said just before, Discord has failed yet again, which I'm not surprised about at all. Okay, I'll bring that down. But anyway, onward and upward, and we'll be rolling into the intro now. I'm back. Marvellous. Okay, that was the intro. I remember to play it this time. Last week we had a bit of a debacle where we didn't actually play the intro. But yes, we'll just go into some news, which, you know, is either exciting or not exciting for those people, but I think it's a very important part. So last week I was reporting about the actual thing that's been going viral at the 18-year-old that had the lung collapse. Hi Bill, how's it going? Hi Maddie. As you can see, Kenny's not here with us tonight. It's just me. Kenny's feeling a bit sick. But yes, going onwards and upwards about, going onwards about the issue, the collapsed lung, we all came to the conclusion that it was a bleb. As it turned out, the black spots weren't damaged caused by vaping. They were actually other blebs, which might I add that it's actually the higher risk of males from the age of 10 to 30 are going to get, what is it? God, I should have looked this up a bit harder. God, this thing goes on for ages. And then you gotta have a look. That's it, told the Daily Mail. Oh God, they know how to drivel on. Though, just for the blebs that could have ruptured. What was it? It was spontaneous pneumothorax, or something along those lines, which is, as I said, at higher risk when you're of certain ages. Hi Pam, hi Ian, thanks for coming along. Yeah, I know, it's what you said last week. It's what I said last week also. So what do we actually learn from this debacle is that people are going to fish for their five minutes of fame, especially in the vaping arena. Now, you know, as I said, this has happened. I mean, obviously vaping may have contributed to it, not causing the damage, but actually exacerbating the damage that was already there, because to burst a bleb You don't really have to do a massive amount. You can take a really deep breath and it'll cause one to rupture. So ipso facto, the vaping was not a direct contributor to it, but it didn't make it any better. So what the bad part of this is that basically, in short, is that we shouldn't be buying up or eating the crap that the media's posting out. So I'm going to actually put it out there to anyone. You know, if you see these outrageous articles that we may know better about, do not share them from directly from the source. Do not even share them of a share from the direct source. Take a screenshot of the actual article, photo, or whatever in question, and post the photo just to not give it any more traction than it's already gone. So if anything, that's what I learned from it. Yes, it is. It's more false news. It really, really is. And also as well, the actual article itself was talking about how potentially the doctor may have lied to the 18-year-old kid to actually deter him from, for the lack of a better term, dueling or vaping on a duel, considering that the 18-year-old hadn't smoked previously before that. So that's how it's, I'm guessing that's how it sort of evolved into a story about how this directly caused these sort of problems. Which is a bit average, to say the least. Yep, okay, we've got some people over at YouTube. How you going? Car surfing. Quaker. I think that's how you pronounce it. Hi. I mean, once again, to those at YouTube, it's not working. Discord's not working yet again, so I can't read messages just in one spot. I better jump around. Yes, well, generally it should be. Well, I'm guessing it is. Well, it is or should be. Should be against the rules to post this non-information, but people still seem to be doing it. And also as well, yeah. But, you know, what's really sad is that you know, there's going to be a lot of people that are vaping, that are potentially going to go back to smoking cigarettes just simply because of this hyperbole media twisted news report. And also another one that I saw is getting about is a handful of people in the US, can't remember exactly where it was, is, you know, suffering lung damage from vaping, when actuality it is THC oil that they've bought in pods off the street which is causing that problem. Yep, there definitely is, Bill. There's a lot. Oh yeah. Yeah, you go blind if you do, yes, definitely. But anyway, yeah, okay, now we'll just jump on over. Oh dear, what have we got? I'm sort of jumping around computers at the moment to try and get these news bits and pieces. The interesting one is Australian government releases info about e-cig scientific inquiry. Which government and scientific used in the same sentence is not going to end up being any good. Okay, so basically, Australia's Liberal Party MPs have long been striving to overturn the current vaping ban. Down under, the device is illegal, as we all know, but vaping nicotine, well, liquid with nicotine in it is not. So, yes. What's that? In August 2016, several public health activists submitted proposals to local regulator Therapeutics Good Administration, the TGA, to remove nicotine concentrates of below 3.6% from the poison standard. However, in February 2017, the TGA rejected the application and upheld the nicotine ban. Okay, but yes, last September during a party room meeting, several MPs had raised the issue once again, saying there was widespread support within the government to legalise nicotine-containing devices. So basically, in short, the government, the details that we've got here is that the grant of $750,000 has been made available for the study since the 27th of February 2019, and the project is expected to be completed by December 2020. Okay, so some of the points that AHTHRA are wanting to have looked at is the primary consideration is to assess the net public health benefit. The fundamental question is, what is the overall net effect of vaping in public health? Do potential benefits of vaping outweigh the potential harms at a population level? Point two that they want looked at is there's also ethical considerations. For example, how should the rights of adult smokers to safer alternatives be weighed against the risk of vaping to adolescents? And three, which regulatory model is most likely to optimize the public health impact of vaping? So some of the options include rescheduling of nicotine. How would vaporizers be classified? Would it be a consumer product, tobacco product, therapeutic, or a combination of all? Specific regulatory issues: sale, manufacturing, importation, distribution, use, product design, including e-liquid ingredients and emissions, advertising, promotion, sponsorship, taxation, health, warning labels, and child safety standards. Strategies to minimize adverse public health effects, such as adolescent uptake and risk proportionate regulation. So there's a few things that the actual study is looking to look at. As to whether or not it goes any further, that would be yet to be seen. So yes, so that is pretty much the news for tonight. Anyone got any sort of ideas that they want to weigh in on and or tally up against it? Because that will be actually interesting to hear what people have to say in regards to this issue. It's always good to have an open discussion about this sort of stuff. But as I said, at the end of the day, I reckon the biggest defining factor as to whether or not we see it legalized in Australia is whether or not we get it limited to particularly one or two devices that the TGA accept and, approve. And you can sure bet that it'll be, TGA approved packaging and stuff for the actual liquid itself. So either way, if it does get approved, does get put forward, you can sure bet that it won't look like the landscape that we've got in vaping shops now. Well, now I can guarantee the TGA will not approve many of the actual juices that we see in the vape shops, let alone as to, well, what do we think could be the loopholes that e-juice companies or vape companies in Australia will have to jump through to be able to sell it? So yes, it's going to be a very interesting couple of years to find out what's going to happen in the end. So what's everyone vaping on today? Hopefully there's a good mix of mods and juice out there. Yes, indeed, a Fallout mug, the Pip Boy. So yes, I've had quite an interesting weekend. Had 2 days down in Geelong with the good crowd down at Geelong Vape Co. That was very, 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 very interesting to see what happens on the other side of the desk. But yes. So what's everyone vaping on tonight? For my mods, as usual, using my Dreamer stacked and the Cali V2 on top. which surprisingly enough, I've managed to damage another cap for it. Damn, there's some classy mods you got there, Maddie. Oh dear. So yes, let's fast forward a little bit further. What we're gonna look at tonight is we've got some actual first views tonight, which is interesting to say the least. Running the Torrent and the Torrent Solo. Walk a pub with Milkman Heritage Smooth. Can't say I've tried that. Okay, now moving along, we're going to jump on to some first views that we've seen kicking about. My God, I cannot read that. The writing is so small. I'll see if I can make that a little bit bigger. Okay, first up, we got the Dovpo MV, well, the M2. Apparently, points of note is the new aesthetic, colourful look and stylish designs. Adjustable voltage range from 1 volt to 8 volt. Multiple protections for a safe vape. Magnetic battery door covers for easy installation of panels. It takes two 18650 batteries. And the size is 91 millimeters tall, 53 millimeters in, I'll say, length, and 27 wide. And it's actually carrying quite a similar look to that of the Invader. Quite an interesting looking mod. So I don't know what people's thoughts on that. Now just be wary with this one. Going on, Kendi. Hey, 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 everyone. Yes, so, yeah. So, as people can see, that this is basically a PWM mod. But almost the same rules apply as using a mechanical mod. Next up, what have we got? I think it's one for the ladies, the Kangatech, and I don't know how to pronounce this. It's either chick or chic. Stylish rivet element, what's that, decoration, attractive lipstick style drip tip, gold plated tank and top grain leather on the mod, 3000 milliamp hour built-in battery with 50 watt max output. It's got soft, normal, hard output modes and multiple protections. The size of this one is 47 millimeters, which I'm guessing is the, we'll say, the length, 29 millimeters wide by 75 millimeters tall. And I don't know, I don't. Yes. Oh, good Lord. Yeah, so, okay, that could be one for the ladies. I don't know. I can guarantee that's not something that I'll personally buy myself for obvious reasons. But yes, there is one that is directly marketed. I don't know. I don't know how I feel about that, guys. How do you guys feel about that? That is, to me, that is very, very tacky. Yes, very tacky. Okay, we're going to be looking at another one this time. We're looking at a mechanical, the MechLife Arcless Slatra. I'm sure I've talked about this. It's got a triple clamp style deck, compatible with 18650, 2700, 21700 batteries, a hybrid, self-adjusting battery contact. We've got one metal button and an extra acrylic button, brass construction, and, well, obviously a resin sleeve, and it is 27 millimeters wide by 91 tall, and the RDA that comes in the package is 25 millimeters by 30 millimeters tall, which I'm only making the assumption that that's including the drip tip. Okay, moving on. Alright, so next we've got the Geekvape Zeus Subohm, the GV Mesh Coil. So saying it's got a purer flavor and greater clouds, direct top airflow and top to bottom airflow, quick slide coil design for easy operation, top juice refilling, capacity of 5 mil, and it's 26 millimeters wide, which I'm assuming is at the bubble, and it's 42.5 in height, and these dimensions are including the drip tips. Don't know much more than that about it. Okay, and for the final one for the evening, now we would have seen this before, but this is a new iteration of it. We've got the Vapefly Brunhilde. Okay, all right, so this one's using the stainless steel wire rope as the actual liquid conduit, I guess. Six levels of airflow to meet your different needs. Easy single coil building deck, convenient side filling on design, and a 5 mil capacity. It's 23 millimeters wide by 65 tall. And as I've been informed previously to the show, that this is actually a mouth to lung version of this atomizer. So here we are back again. Interesting to see them back again, Vapefly. They've been making quite a big splash with their MTL sort of atomizers. RDTA or RTA, that's an interesting one. That would be a more of a Genesis RTA, because the steel wire ropes that go to the bottom of the tank are used to suck up the juice, and you sort of place your cotton that's from the coil on top of the stainless steel ropes, so it draws all the way through. So sort of, yeah. John, hi mate, how are you? Kenny's not with us today in body, but he is here in spirit, and he's in the chat room. Well, there you go. Not overly weird, Pam. Over in EU, there is a couple of atomizers that use this arrangement, and apparently they're quite good. They're quite good. But yes. All right. Now that we've jumped up to FaceTime, now I think it'll be a perfect moment to have a look at the mystery shop, which has been done for us by Matty Smith, if he's still here. Hope he is. So yeah, it's a bit of a slow night tonight. It's just me tonight. I can clearly see that it's very slow all over the place. And if Kendi's still in there, tried what you suggested to do with Discord, still doesn't work. Okay, so we'll jump down to the top down and we will have a look. Boom, there we go. Now, obviously for privacy reasons, I've scribbled out the address. Sent by Express, so I feel very fancy, Express. Yes. Just a quick tune in, Scotty. No one knows what anyone got anyone yet. So this is going to be interesting. And the package itself has come from Mr. Devices. So this is going to be interesting. We'll go and have a look. Here we go. Ooh. And this has been sitting in the cupboard for the last few days. So it'll be interesting to finally see what's in it. Now, do I have anything here to open it? Gosh darn it. Probably don't, knowing my luck. I wonder if this will be sharp enough to do it. And it is. Oh no, I've got it. It's all good, thank you. Let's have a look. Oh, it's probably not really in view there. Hey. Let's have a look, we'll get rid of these. Little beans, which you can lick and they dissolve, which can be quite fun. Yes, we've got lollies, definitely got lollies. Let's have a look, we've got a trolley alligator. I love these little trolley lollies. And a chop chop lollipop. Look at that. Light side, nice sticker there. 888 vape sticker, Australia. Me good. Jackrabbit vapes, which is actually funny because I'm looking at a Jackrabbit's vapes juice today. Holy spadooly. And the lollies keep going. Bit of Mentos and, here we go. Regency juice. Noni, Madison, Georgia. And Miranda. Now, I've heard about these Regency ones by Haku. So it'll be interesting to see how these juices actually go. We put that to the side, and we are looking also at cotton. Fire Button cotton and Cloud 9 cotton. Premium 100% organic cotton, super fast absorb, fast switching flavour, resist high temp. Interesting, intriguing. Thank you very much, Maddie, for doing that shop for us. That would be awesome. And it is awesome. Let's have a look. I'll sit there and bring it up. Let's have a look. Regency Vapor. I like the stickers. Especially the Jackrabbit. Right. The Triple H. So I don't know how Kendi feels about that. It looks pretty bloody good from here. Hey, Sean. Cloud 9. It looks like there's a bit of going for Cloud 9 at the moment. Yes. Well, we can sure bet that these cottons will be making their way into Heat 2 of the Cotton Grand Prix when we get a few more. We're still waiting for one titanium fibre. What is it? Titanium fibres or titanium fibre cotton. We'll be checking that out in the upcoming shows. But first, we'll have a bit of a sticky beak at this actual cotton. I love cotton. I tried another one the other day, Holy Fiber. I think that's what it's called. Oh, look at that. That's interesting. My word. Colour me impressed, Maddie Smith. Thank you very much. And I'm going to have a sticky beak at this one as well. Where's Kendi? Is he even in here anymore? Oh, you ordered TFC, not whatever that is. Okay, well, no harm, no foul. Oh, that's quite reminiscent of cotton bacon. So that'll be interesting to see how that goes too. Cloud 9, Interesting. We'll have a look at these. Also, the Regency vapor or Regency juice. I've heard very good things about them. We'll jump on there. You're gonna fill your pillows, eh? Okay, well, that's interesting. That's actually going to be very interesting. All right, I'm going to go back in. We're going to jump back up to FaceTime. That is awesome. Thank you very much, Maddie, for doing that for us. Looks like there's a fair bit of stuff to have a look at here. Intrigued orange pineapple lemonade. Okay. And that's an interesting looking sticker right there. I mean, it really is. But yes, and we'll have a look at those juices. All right, let's have a look. Oh, wait a second. There was an easier, more direct. Mr. Devices. We'll jump into Mr. Devices page and we'll have a look at them from there. Okay, what have we got? The first one that I am looking at is Madison. Isabel, Jews are in the wall. Come on, where's Rebecca? Madison, let's have a look. Okay, the first one that we're going to have a bit of a sticky beak at. Strawberry, Madison, strawberry orange marmalade. That's going to be intriguing because I'm a massive fan of marmalade. From the finger taste, it's actually quite tasty. Very sort of candy strawberry for that one. Quite tasty. Okay, then we'll look at, what are we looking at? The next one is Georgia. We'll go back. Georgia, we'll have a sticky beak at Georgia. I think it's quite interesting that they're actually all named, well, female named, that's not to say, which is a lychee. Which I will also taste. Holy crap. That's the first time I've ever tasted a lychee juice, and it's almost tasted like I've taken a bite of a, well, maybe a canned lychee, an actual lychee. That is actually quite good. We'll have a look at Noni. And I will have a bit of a vape on these. Throughout the show. Oh, crikey Moses. I'm actually quite well, like I actually really like the look of the actual bottle as well. It's pretty straightforward. Very simple, like very see-through, so you can actually see the actual liquid. Get a good idea of the colour behind it. Pretty much every single one I've put my hand on so far is almost clear. So what was that? That was a Noni. And we'll have a look at that. Where are we? Alicia, Edmund, Madison. Noni, there's Noni down there. Yeah, it's good. Thanks for the thought, Maddie. As I said, love marmalade. Strawberry cinnamon donut filled with jam for Noni. Interesting. And then we'll look at Miranda. God, I actually feel bad just saying the names out. And then, yeah, I'm looking at Miranda, and I've just turned over to my laptop to find it. Where are we? Miranda. Creamy lemon tart. Wow. Oh, Yep. Okay. Where's Kendi? Kendi's sick tonight, Jade. Noni. Wait a sec, I've got to go back again to find Noni. Georgia. Noni, I'll double check that. That was the donut, strawberry donut with jam. Not quite sure on that just by finger tasting it, but as we all know that not always they, well, they don't always taste as they do, when you vape them, as the finger taste. Interested about the cotton. Yeah, that's intriguing. Okay. Well, Jesus, just by finger tasting already, I'm getting the solid feeling that I'm going to be up for something, something special. And if the juice is even half the quality of their atomizers, so I see, then I'm going to be really up for something. So I'm going to actually dry this out. I'm going to try this. I'm going to try Noni first and give that a bit of a drip and a bit of a shot. Just wait for that to dry out because I've been going absolutely smack happy on the custard shop, Blackberry, and I've been hitting a Jackrabbit. Banoffee pie just recently. So this is my first ever experience or with well Regency or well, Regency juice by Haku. So to be honest, I'm actually expecting really big things. I can smell it. To me, I'm getting a very sort of candy strawberry. Michael, Mick, what do I think of the blackberry custard shop? I'm liking it. I like berry and custard. I wasn't 100% sure. I mean, this one, when I was down at the shop, I'd been sort of running backwards and forwards, sort of questioning as to whether or not to go to the custard shop. But yeah, I did the, yeah, I took the dive on the blackberry, and it's actually quite nice. You do get the nice. Not an overpowering blackberry, but yeah. Oh, what? No crackle. God damn, here we go with the crackle again. Yeah, no crackle. Not much anyway. It's only a very simple round wire at the moment. I'm going to have to agree with you there, Ali, Addy. Addy, sorry. That's not quite as punchy as I sort of. What's going on, Maddie? Addy, I'm not finding it overly punchy. I would have liked the jam to highlight a little bit more. I'm getting a little bit of the strawberry, the baked of the donut. I haven't tried the custard tart yet, Pam. I've tried the date. Sticky date pudding, I wasn't that impressed, but I think that might have been because I went with a doubler, perhaps. But yeah. You know what would almost be a better device to try this on is try this on my Citadel. But that's not to say it's a bad juice, because it's not a bad juice. I don't think it's a bad juice, but just not quite as punchy as I'd hoped. But I'm only making this assumption that, I would actually. Yep, no worries, Mick. I'll catch up with you later. I'm only making the assumption that these will probably taste so much better on an actual Haku atomizer. I know it sounds so weird, but yeah. Because I can tell that there's some notes sitting in there, but yeah. Need something a little more refined to hit it with, I reckon. Rightio, so that was the noni, which is strawberry donut and jam. Okay, what are we going to look at next? Georgia. Come here, Georgia. Let's decap you and drip you. You laughing? Oh, where'd Georgia go? I lost Georgia. Sabrina, Rebecca. Oh my God. Did you have any idea how odd it is to be saying this? Okay, let's have a look at Georgia again. We'll have a look at her in fine detail. Okay, this is the lychee. This is the one that I thought, oh, wacko, like an actual lychee. What? Stop laughing, Pauline, you're making me laugh. I sound, I feel dirty saying these names. Yeah, maybe a gas. Now that is a lychee that I recognize. The flavor of that is almost like I've taken a bite of a lychee. That is how it's meant to be done. That is how it's meant to be done, guys. That is not too sweet, not too mellow enough to sort of give you the sense that you're eating a lychee. Yeah. Yeah, I can see why, Maddie, why it'd be one of your favorites. Wow. I feel guilty just sitting here not trying these without Kenny. Yeah, Pam, you'll find them at Mr. Devices. Mr. Devices or Regency Vapor Lounge, I think, in Sydney. See, I think with these ones, John, is that I think that these ones are very highly refined flavors. I think that's where it was going with these. But yeah, that is definitely a lychee. No, generally, lychee doesn't have a cooling effect naturally. Yeah, beers don't work. You don't think they sell them offline, Mr. Devices? Oh, a second. Mr. Devices only have half the range, sadly. Okay. Oh, they don't sell them on. I think. No, I'm pretty sure I saw them online for sale, possibly. Yeah, I think I have. Weird, I know. Wow, it's a long time since I've been impressed by a fruit. Georgia, be my girl. Okay, that is great. That is just sort of, yes. Okay. Now to sort of collect myself and have a vape after that exciting experience with Georgia. Okay, I'm gonna have a look at Madison now. I'm sorry, these just here, yeah, these names. Madison, where art thou? Okay, Madison, the strawberry orange marmalade. I'll go a finger taste again. The smell of it, I'm getting strawberry straight off the bat. That's an interesting one. Because, yeah, straight up on. Yeah, Regency sell online. There we go. Nice. Okay. Straight up on. I'm getting the strawberry foremost. It's taken a little bit for me to actually come around to the actual orange itself. I'll have to have another hit of that. Yeah, on the second go, I'm starting to get the orangey and the marmalade-y sort of thing. I don't know. I think with that one, the strawberries made it more of a jam, more so than a marmalade. A good juice. They're pretty well put together, that's for sure. Australia, yeah. Keep it coming. Very much undecided on that one. Good juice. Good juice. I would have liked it to have had a little bit more orange, a bit more marmalade. And instead of the strawberry taking the limelight, I would have liked the orange a bit more.
But once again, another well put together juice. I'm not going to rate these.
Okay. Now, last but not least, Miranda. Whoa. What's that? Yes, medicine has taken my breath away. Okay, over to Miranda, which is the creamy, homemade creamy lemon tart. And quite frankly, after trying four different girls in one night, I'm starting to feel like a creamy lemon tart.
Now that's also very delicious as well. Rightio.
Definitely getting the mouthfeel of the creaminess. Crust of the tart, lemon, definitely there. Not a lemon, but more of a, like a, oh, what am I thinking? Like a curd lemon. That is really, really good. Maddie, you've made me into a believer. You've really made me into a believer. Wow. Four girls, 20 minutes. I feel like an NBA star. Wow. Excellent. That is really good. So anyone that's hesitant about trying Regency e-liquid by Haku, no reservations. Go out, get it, check it out. Wow. That is something else. Righty-o. Okay, now that I've got my breath back. So which ones were for who, Maddie? That'd be interesting to see. Because, I'm thinking the donut and lychee would have been probably for Kendi, because he does love his donut. Possibly. And the marmalade and lemon, creamy lemon tart for myself. Oh dear. Yeah, they're good. That was an excellent mystery shop. And the cotton, yeah. That's going to be another interesting thing as well. Yeah, it was a really, really good shop. And just to remind you guys also as well, we do this once a month. And we do a random draw where, people will yep, we'll take the viewers' names, put them in a randomizer, and we'll pick out that monthly shop or the shopper. Oh, wow. That's even making my sweet cup of coffee bitter. That is really good. Wow. Okay, what more to be said? Okay, so it looks like we've only made it through an hour of the show so far. I'm thinking maybe, I'm probably looking to actually probably re-wick. But I don't have any of my gear on me. Bub, can you have a look in that big grey box to see if you can find a little Vandy vape bag that's got all my stuff in it, please? And then I'll try a little bit of the cotton. But yeah, top marks. Wow. Yeah, yeah, that's the one, thank you. Because I've been actually looking at Regency juice for a little bit. And I mean, I knew that it was probably going to be a reasonably high quality, given that, they've been constructed by the dude that's done the Haku. Well, Haku Engineering. Yes, I think they are, Maddie. Yeah, it's probably a good idea as well, yeah. Definitely at $18 a six from the Regency. $20 from Mr. Devices, which, I mean, $2 extra, $20 a 60ml bottle is still not an arm and a leg. And it is a very, very, very high quality. I'd say it's a high quality juice, that one. Definitely. Now, I'm going to give a bit of a lash to this Cloud9 cotton. Only using enough to re-wick. And then I'll have a look at the juices that I bought in for the show. time to pull this out and then re-wick, I think. The coils are looking a little manky. It's always good to try new cotton as well. Looking a bit sketchy. But yeah, no, very, very good quality juice. Yeah, bloody hell. But I reckon those juices will absolutely sing on something that's only a single coil and very, very... I think they'll absolutely sing in a single coil, very airflow orientated single coil Addy. I mean, they were good in this, and you know, the Cali V2 isn't exactly a bad RDA, but I just think that they're just going to be just that bit better in the single coil Addy. What was it? It was Georgia. Miranda, Madison, and Noni. Very high class girls. Oh yeah, we'll try a bit of this cotton, which at the moment I'm trying the Cloud 9, which will be interesting. Because it looks to be quite a reasonable cotton, especially from the feel, nice and soft, not overly matted, obviously not massively linear in the way of the cotton fiber lay, probably say it more looks very similar to Cotton Bacon Pro, but softer. So yeah, you probably could quite easily make a pillow out of it. Just got this really odd feeling that it would actually draw like crazy. And we'll pop that in there. Okay, I'm gonna be using a bit of the custard shop. Absorbs pretty well. So all that's really going to come down to is whether or not it's got a bit of a burn in time or not. And whether or not it's got a... It's got a burn in taste. Or a cottony taste to begin with. Don't find a difference between TFC and Cloud 9, okay. Almost zero first hit flavour. Well, no cottony sort of flavour, just flavour of the juice. Getting those mellow blackberry notes of that custard shop. But yes, it's actually not too bad at the get-go. But yeah, I think it's Holy Fiber. The cotton that I've been using recently, Holy Fiber. We'll have a look at that Holy Fiber cotton. We'll have a look at that. That's one that I was given a sample of down at the shop. try out. Its description is, Holy Fiber pushes the limits of your vaping experience. Extremely absorbent and specifically developed to enhance the flavour. Okay, made from high-end cellulose fibre. You'll discover the taste of your e-liquid. Innovative production process and high level of purity. Has been analysed by an independent and certified laboratory. Holy Fiber is 100% tasteless, heat resistant, and offers much more durability than traditional cotton. Yes, it's actually quite intriguing to see how many cottons are out there. My experience with the Holy Fiber, from what I read, it's quite capable of up to 400 degrees before it burns. However, yeah, it's going good, Adam. Going good, just kicking along. My experience with Holy Fiber was that it did have a bit of a taste at the beginning, which sort of calmed down. And even when I sort of tried to have a massive dry hit, it sort of didn't really give me much of a dry hit, even though it did give me a bit of a it wasn't as bad as what some others could have been. But but that being said, I pretty much just used it in my stacked mod, so anything that was going to hit that was going to hit it hard. So yeah. So yeah, so Cloud 9. Don't know as to whether or not it'll improve the flavour of juice. Quite absorbent. That much I will say. Back to that creamy lemon tart. Pretty funny and not unusual that I gravitate towards the lemon tart. But yeah, they're quite nice juice. The Cloud 9 cotton, quite good, no burning whatsoever. You can pretty much taste the flavour from the get-go. Fibre and cotton. Interesting. But yes, I'll look further into those cottons and report back next week. Or we could just, minimalise the use of it, see how it goes a little bit, and then save it for the Cotton Grand Prix. Yeah, not reviewing just yet, Noni, but if that Noni was the, well, one of the ones that you created, it was delicious. I've got to commend you on your juice mixing ability for starters, but how to get that lychee to actually taste like a lychee. That's magic. Oh, so she's the house juice maker. Rightio, there you go. But we'll probably look deeper into these juices next week and probably do a bit of a rundown review. I liked, just off the bat, Miranda. And I have to say, I do feel dirty saying all these females' names. Okay, touche. I'll give you that one, Matt. Loved Miranda. Very creamy, delicious Taste the crust, almost like a light lemon curd in that. Really nice.
Did she wash?
Huh?
Did she wash?
Did she wash?
Yeah.
Dunno. Now, I'm just going to double check that one again. Georgia. But yeah, very well made. Oh yes, Bobby, I won't say any other women's names apart from when it comes talking to juice. Talking about juice. One second, no, the Georgia, sorry. Yeah, Georgia was... Was it? Yeah, no, the Georgia was the lychee, sorry. I'm getting myself confused. So, Georgia, lychee. But yeah, Georgia, the lychee in Georgia was absolutely delicious. What was Madison? God, I'm losing names. Madison, that's right, Madison. That's right, the orange marmalade. I'll have a smack of that again now that I've tried a different cotton. But yeah, that creamy lemon tart, delicious. Lychee, delicious. Strawberry orange marmalade, getting the slight orange in it, but yeah, sort of hope there was a little bit more orange in it. Definitely getting the strawberry, definitely getting the jammy stuff. But still a tasty juice nonetheless. And what was Miranda? Miranda, there we are, there you are. Oh dear, that was the lemon tart, sorry, my bad. And Noni was, I'm assuming. That was the... Noni. And I'm thinking that was the strawberry donut. Strawberry cinnamon donut filled with jam. Right. Yes. Unfortunately, the Noni, I'm sorry Noni if you're watching still, wasn't my particular kind of juice. But, as I say, and as I say every time when it comes to tasting juice, this is just purely my opinion only. And at the end of the day, it is still a very well constructed juice. There's just a couple more things that I would have loved in that, but it's obviously selling well for you guys, so more power to you. But the other ones, absolutely phenomenal. And I am actually now looking forward to trying more. But yes, if my wife actually vaped, then I'll get her to try them also. And I love it how they're like 80-20. Perfect. But yes, well done. Well done. But yeah, as I said, I'll be interested to see how these juices go in a single coil, more designed flavour atomizer. Because as I said, I reckon those will sing. I'll try Noni one more time. Just a few drips. Banging and stuff around. Jesus.
Stop calling other people names.
So it's nice, but yeah. Not my kind of donut. It smells good too. But yeah. So yeah, I reckon we'll be putting those up for review next week to have a good look at them. And I, for one, say to anyone that's viewing the show tonight, check them out. Check out Regency. Regency. Find a flavour profile that suits you in that. I doubt that you'll be disappointed. Because I'm not. Even ones that I don't normally, flavours that I don't normally vape, good. And if that lychee does make its way to Kendi, I will definitely be getting myself a bottle of it. But yes, it is a bit quiet tonight. I apologise, doing just a one person show. Huh? But yeah, glad that you guys have joined, checking it out. Pauline can fill in for Candy.
Who?
Pauline, you.
Who said that?
Nick.
I offered.
You probably should.
No idea what to say.
Oh, wow. These juices are really good. I don't know what more to say, really. God damn it. I want to keep them all for myself. But I can't. They're really good. But anyway, so, guys. Any questions out there at all? Anything? Let's just get this conversation rolling, guys. Been going for a bit. Put together a bit of a special Skittles episode for tonight. The Skittles video that I put together tonight is random. Hmm? Oh, there's a little thing. Oh, buddy. Oh, there you are, matey. Yeah, Dougie's going through a few problems at the moment. He's a bit allergic to the grass outside. Have to share. Yes, I know, I have to share. It saddens me. But that's a very, very well put. Yes, Doug's here. He's kicking about. He's taken a bit of a liking to dodging the grass since it's so waterlogged out the front. And he's sort of getting on the curbside to run up the front yard. Getting a bit close to traffic for me. Yes, he does have a rash. He's got a rash under his front arm, paw, leg, whatever they call it. And a little bit in between his toes. A little while back he was actually given steroids for it. We're going to have to put him back on it. Poor little bugger. But on that note, I'm going to be jumping to a bit of this. So hold on to your hats, guys. I hope that this mix is good for tonight. So we're going to jump over to this one.
A rainbow.
Me. Take a closer look at that snout.
I've ever seen.
So it would seem.
She's a wolf in mouse clothing.
Ah!
The mouse's ghostly howl stakes claim to
their tongue is Dovahkiin, Dragonborn.
All rainbow.
Pinky is a very loving cat.
Pinky.
Pinky, whoa.
Just disconnected from the day.
Dude, do you think this coffee is strong?
Dudes, check out this giant fucking Zippo I bought. This motherfucker's bigger than a deck of cards, like.
Do something, cat.
Millie's my favorite. Look how calm she is as well.
season, we're asking six big questions. On this episode, how smart are animals?
I feel good. I knew that I wouldn't.
What kind of dog is that?
What you want me to do with this? Eat it. Happy birthday to the crack.
And I am back. Yep, we're back, we're working, we're talking. And that was tonight's episode of Random Skit Video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. And that's basically the bulk of the main show done. So pretty much it's an open floor now for anyone that wants to ask any questions or just general chit-chat. What are you planning for the upcoming weekend? Or, you know, yeah, well, I'm hoping to get better and better at putting skit videos together. Even though it's realistically only four videos that I've just cut and sliced and put together. No. Probably not enough lewd humour in it. Candy, yeah, you gotta look forward to trying these Regency juices. No, it's not actually the end of the show. I've still got these two juices to have a look at. For the review section. First up, I'm going to be putting in the custard shop blackberry. Get this down at the Geelong vape shop and probably some other reputable vape resellers. What else was in the mystery shop? Handful of lollies. Stickers. 888 vapes. Light side, I don't know exactly what that is, and a Jackrabbit vape sticker. Cloud 9 cotton. And also fiber and cotton, which I've just had a bit of a sneaky peek at. And apparently, according to someone here, there's not too much difference between the Cloud 9 and the titanium. But there, once again, that just all comes down to personal opinion. The mystery shop. So yeah, that was what was in the mystery shop. Oh, and also, sorry. Four delicious girls from Regency. So I don't know, take your pick on that one, Kenny. Yes, that's right. That's what I said as soon as I looked at it. More cotton for the Grand Prix part two. I'm trying a bit of the Cloud 9 at the moment and it's proven to be pretty good. But yeah, what am I doing? Looking at the custard shop, blackberry, dripping it away in my Cali V2. reasonably creamy, light custard. Sweet, definitely sweetener in it. A very light blackberry. Not too strong on. I would have liked the both the custard and the blackberry to be a little more present. Makes for a good vape. I dare say that it'll be pretty damn good by the time when I get halfway through the bottle. Well, actually, I've gone through a little bit at the moment. Let it sit for a while. I reckon that'll be absolutely sweet at 2 weeks. Out of five. I'll give it about a 3.2. It's not a bad vape. Not an overly pungent custard either. Sometimes you get customers, but yeah, one thing that actually is left out from this juice is the creamy mouthfeel. It is lacking in the creamy mouthfeel department, but it is quite a reasonably well put together one, but probably only a 3. But I reckon that'll sort of age, that'll be a good ager, and I reckon that it'd probably be a bit better in 2 weeks' time. Comes out of the USA. don't know if it's done by the same company, but I don't know, probably. But the cream team, a couple of other ones are also listed on the inside lid of the box for this. Not a bad juice at all, but yeah, probably needs a bit more time to mature up that flavour. Yeah, probably a bread bin steep for the custard shop. It's not bad, not bad. It's just sort of lacking a bit of creaminess. I'll finish up on this one. Definitely over the halfway mark out of the rating of 5, that's for sure. But yeah. God, my belt's done up too tight. Okay, now the next one I'm looking at is out of the UK, Jack Rabbit Vapes Banoffee Pie. This is probably more my speed. Actually, I'll step back to this one. Definitely more of a light, eggy sort of custard in that. Not so much the heavy, heavy sort of, almost like packet custard. More of a light one. Definitely. Now looking at the Jack Rabbit Vapes. I tried this one at Geelong Vapes, the Geelong Vape Co. Loved it. But, you know, another dessert. Reasonably well put together. I think the Jackrabbit Vapes, well, of course there's more. I'll have a look to see what else is in there. Flavor range. UK, first established in Oxford by two lifelong friends and vape fanatics since 2015. Josh and Torin have prided themselves on making unique, complex flavours. Okay, but what is there? Also got new from the creators of Jackrabbit, they've also got Rachel Rabbit. Which I'll have a bit of a look into. Have a look. Which the other, what's that, Rachel Rabbit, more fruits. So you've got lemon, pear and raspberry, orange, mango, passion fruit, pomegranate, kiwi and watermelon in that range. Whew. Okay, Jack Rabbit, they've got Banoffee Pie, which I'm looking at tonight. They've got the other one, which I really like, the Raspberry White Cookie. And they've got Arroyo, which is a tropical flavor. Interesting. Fresh, juicy pineapple that gives a sweet punch on the inhale with papaya mango, followed by a delicate touch of coconut cream. Coconut and cream. For Rio, Mandarin Cheesecake, which I didn't actually like. Blueberry Duffin. Blueberries added to perfect mix, light fluffy muffin. And sweet donut base. Interesting. And a succulent strawberry. And that's the six flavors in the Jackrabbit. Which is more of a fruit one, which is, yes, strawberry on the inhale and a bit of a cooling effect on the exhale on that one. But tonight, as I said, I'm looking at their Banoffee Pie. Now the Banoffee Pie, what more can I say? Banana. Dolce de leche caramel, cookie base, delicious, very well proportioned. A bit on the sweet, definitely a bit of sweetener in there, not too much. I haven't noticed too much in the way of bad coil action. That one is sitting at least around a four. Straight on the inhale, you get the banana and you get the slight sort of a fried caramelized banana. And then it sort of mellows out with the caramel notes sort of, you know, playing around in the middle. And then on the exhale, and also on the back of the, sort of like the back of the initial flavor, then you slightly get the base. So yeah, it's actually quite a well off juice. I like it. I'm probably going to sit that one at about a 3.8, possibly a 4. I love banana, cooked banana, baked banana, any sort of banana like that. And it's not, you're not left with any sort of aftertaste, really, except for the light little sprinklings of banana. But yeah, very, very well balanced, very well layered. As I said, I sort of enjoy how it dances between the different layers of the flavor. You start off with the definitely a cooked banana, caramelized banana, and then the sweetness of the caramel and sort of creaminess to the caramel as well. And then sort of a very nice finisher of a really nice base to it. No, not overly candy banana, no. This is very much a more natural cooked banana. Very tasty. Yeah, I don't mind a bit of candy banana either, actually, to be honest. But yeah. A very tasty drop. And the quality, as I said, the quality is really good with it. Very, as I said, well balanced, plays really well. And I can say sort of the same for the what one was it? The Raspberry White Cookie, that was delicious as well. Which that one is a dreamy white chocolate, creamy tones of vanilla surrounded by chewy cookie dough, complemented with the perfect blend of sweet and tangy raspberry, and it's not far wrong. But yeah, a really well mixed juice yet again to come out of the UK. which is in very stark contrast to some of the other juices I've tasted from the UK. But yes, I've been spoilt for choice for juices tonight, so thanks again to Maddie Smith for being our mystery shopper for this month. That's a very awesome shop. It furthers the show and it introduces me to another very well done line of juices. Well, what I've tasted so far. So yes, I will be eventually making my rounds and I will be getting more of the Regency, that's for sure, once I have a very good solid look to see what the other flavours are. But just by tasting that small variety of different juices, what's happening with the Dougie? He's gone down to rest now. Having a bit of a snooze. Having a bit of a relax before I go to work tonight. Which is good. Like it when he's all relaxed. And the Doug. What's happening with the Doug? Okay, alright. It's interesting that someone brought that up. I've been using mine for weeks and stuff now. Well, what's happening with that? I've finalised the final settings with the 3D printer. I'm still yet to print it off. Done a lot of refining, so any time that's been between me showing it or sort of announcing it to now has been basically spent refining the design, which it pretty much looks the same. Just some small little changes here and there. Nothing to the internals, it's pretty much right there, but definitely a lot of time spent on the print settings. Now, yeah, work's been getting sort of busy, so I will be back to getting that done a bit later. A bit later this month, and I'll just double check everything. I will be starting to get them ready to print and put together from the 2nd of September will be when the finals are getting done. Yeah. Oh yeah, the 3D printers are banes of anyone's existence, Pam. Even if you spend a lot of money on them. The main changes and the squonk, yeah, I was talking about the squonk, I don't know. Wait a sec, yeah. Oh, I thought we were talking about the squonk. What's wrong with that? Sorry, I'm getting myself confused. Main changes that have been done has not been an actual, not so much in the way of, aesthetic changes. Just a bit of extra curving on the edges to make it a bit softer in the hand. That's all that's been done. A few other smaller changes to the print, the 3D design, that's an actual, to fix up any problems that may occur when it comes to finishing them, like giving them a finish. That's really all that's changed in that regard. But other than that, the only changes that have been made, have, as I said, have been sort of machining changes on how it prints it. They can. Yeah, rounding on the edges is a good idea. Well, I've already had rounding on the edges, but more the edges that, not so much the ones on the main corners, but just when it sits in your hand. But yeah, as Kenny's pointed out, there is a lot of smaller little settings that you've got to get right before you commit to making something. And yeah, they can break down. I mean, you just got to think that these things are doing, you know, prints in, you know, running for, you know, 7 or 8 hours non-stop. When they're put to duty cycle. But yeah, other than that, largely it looks pretty much the same. But yeah, it's just the way that the slicing software interprets the 3D model. And then also as well, the slicing software that you decide to use with it. Each and every bit of software has its own little quirks that you have to work out and work around. And yeah, and also as well, me wanting the best product that I can come up with, well, the colors can be done. The colours themselves are either going to get represented in the doors for them, or they're going to be done in clear variants of the colours, if that makes any sense. Like a translucent, like if someone wants red, it's not going to be a solid red, it's going to be a translucent red. Yeah, but stuff like black, solid black and solid white, or any sort of solid colors, are going to be represented on the doors. Not so much the mod itself, that's more of a reliability thing. Because yeah, due to the material being what it is, it can be varying different settings from color to color. Yeah, it will be interesting. As I said, the first three that are going to be done are going to be, they're all going to be natural bodies, which is sort of like a clear body, which is what I've done with mine. And they're going to have the choices of clear black or white doors. And also as well, a little bit down the track, I'll be offering I'll be offering colored doors as an option. And I will be replacing the internals, the contacts, eventually with 999 fine silver, which will, in the next batch or the batch after that that gets made, which will be offered as a as an inbuilt thing, like straight out of the box or whatever it comes in. But to those people that purchase it originally, where it's using the silver plated, beryllium copper will get offered the 999 fine silver contacts at a discount as an upgrade. It's still ongoing. Don't worry, it's still ongoing. But me being me, I'm trying to make sure I get the best product that I can get out. And you know, at the end of the day, also, I still haven't decided exactly, you know, how it's going to arrive to people's hands. Like what sort of packaging, if any sort of packaging, or is it just going to come in a nice bag, or, yeah. But one thing I can say is that they're as strong as, yeah. Yeah, they're as strong as, for instance, here's a black one that I was working on. With sandblasting it, and the plastic itself is that resilient to abrasion that I even had the sandblaster at 70 or 80 psi, pelting sand at it, and it only just sandblasted the surface. And I've been strength testing this particular version of it, which is about 98% what the product will be, and I can't break it, well, not by hand, or it hasn't cracked by dropping. I've just been making sure that the models themselves have been coming out really strong. There's a few issues which are sort of like I've had to over-engineer for those particular issues, because unfortunately, 3D printing is 3D printing. You're never going to get anything 100% perfect. But as I said, I'm just making sure that it's the absolute best that I can offer at the time. Drop test. I've already drop tested this one, this particular version of the body. I mean, look, I'm. Oh, that wasn't the mod. That was actually my knuckles. Like, this is the box itself. There we go. And that was using two hands to do that. So dropping generally didn't affect it, but me putting all my strength into it, both hands did. So here you are, you've actually had a live on-cam pressure test of the actual mod. And what's interesting is the way that it actually cracked. Because here, if I squeeze it, and if you can see that, you can sort of see it. Oh, wait a second, see if I can turn that away, you can see it. You can see the way that the cracks have come through that. And it hasn't cracked on a layer level, it's cracked through the layers. So that's actually quite a strong box, actually. So it can be broken, but by Christ, did that like take a lot of effort. But yeah, general dropping and stuff like that will generally not damage it. And very little in the way of damage actually done to it from dropping it. So I'm pretty happy, actually happy with that. Oh, that wasn't a sign of how, well, I am reasonably strong, but that's, and yeah, so let's have a look at that actually. It's good that it actually did that. Oh, bloody hell. Oh, Christ. Oh, yeah, okay. So that's actually taken a lot of effort to actually finish it off. Well, it is very tough. It's reasonably tough, yeah. It takes a lot of bloody toughness to bloody crack it too. Jesus. But yeah, so they're the kind of things that I'm just trying to make sure. And I know that if I dropped a piece of Delrin from that sort of height, it would have chipped or cracked, or even if it was resin, it probably would have shattered. Yeah, side pressure is a massive factor. But yeah, see, that's what I'm sort of talking about, like, especially when it comes to those particular walls in either side, like the battery and the squonk bottle in that area. They're big areas for concern. But, you know, that being said, I'll flip down to a top down just quickly. I'll see if we can actually see it. We could probably get a better look at it from here. Oh, wait a sec. See, as you can see, you can, oh, geez, that's not gonna do too well. Just bear with me 1 second. Properties, there we go, configure video. I'll see if I can fix this up a little bit. See, as you can see in there, that's the point of failure. Right, oh, wait a sec, right through there, which normally when you're looking for actual points of failure in 3D prints, you're looking in these linear lines for where they crack. But for it to crack actually through the actual layers and then through to the back, it's actually got quite a lot of strength in that. And also, while we're down here looking at it, you can sort of see some of the other, see if we can get that right, you can see some of the other details inside of it. Not that you're getting a great view, sorry. Let's see if I can fix that up. There we go. That's what it looks like sandblasted, but obviously in there as well, I've made another addition with the actual battery orientation with it as well. The inside also takes a massive amount of effort to actually snap that, and once again it's cracked through the layers. But yeah, but that's why we sort of do that sort of testing to see how strong they are, which they're actually surprisingly damn strong. But yeah, anyway, but yeah, but yeah, so, you know, and that's the sort of stuff that I try to, yeah, the kind of stuff that I try to get edge out of it. But yeah, as you can see, it took a massive amount of effort to break it. And I'm not ashamed to show that it, you know, that it does break, and I can guarantee you that, you know, other mods would do the same sort of thing with that sort of pressure on those areas. But yeah. But yeah, but as I said, I mean, look, it's only, as I said, at the end of the day, it's a bit of plastic. It takes a massive amount of effort. There's no actual real massive amount of delamination between the actual prints, and that's why we muck around with the settings when we do actually print. So yeah, so as you can see and as you can tell, it's still getting a lot of stuff sorted with it. Now you're on my channel today. Yeah, I was sort of going through the sort of looking at what sort of pressures it would take to snap my mod, which actually took a massive amount. So yeah, general wear and tear and use will not be too much of a factor for this mod. Yeah, I do like Jai Hayes. He's great. But yeah, so that's the stress test of the Doug mechanical squonker. And yeah, as I look over it, I dropped that at about 6 foot. Nothing in it, unfortunately, but at about, you know, 5.5, 6 foot. Very impact resistant and didn't leave really any marks when it hit a tile floor. So I'm pretty actually quite happy with that. Yeah, that's it. It's very unlikely that you would see pressures like that in the way of vaping. I've also tested it like, I can't exactly test it exactly heat-wise, like to the exact degree when vaping on it, but I haven't noticed any warping through the plastic layers or anything when using it generally to vape as well. So it's actually quite robust, which I was sort of uncertain of when it came first use of the actual material, but it's shown to be damn strong, very resistant to heat, except for like major amounts of force exerted onto it, and then it did buckle and break. But yeah. So yeah, I'm actually pretty thrilled with that. Is this the new one? This one I was looking at was pretty much how it'd be printed, but it was an older version of the model. I've made a couple of different changes to it, where it's got more rounded front and rear edges, not so much on the corners near the button or the atomizer and the top and bottom, but where the door goes in and on the back are gonna be more rounded. And then several other settings that have been changed on the print level. It wasn't resistant to me. I sort of hoped that it wasn't going to break, but as I said, I'm glad that it did break because it showed me exactly how it is going to break. And most of the breaks themselves, instead of being, as most people know, or you may not know, the way the 3D printer prints it prints in layers. And the weakest point usually is where the previous layer meets up to the new layer when it bonds on a new layer. But this snapped through the layers with a very uniform break throughout the layers, which would normally be normal fracture points if it was an injection molded piece of plastic. So actually I'm pretty thrilled that it actually did break the way that it did, because it shows that the bond between layers are pretty damn good. But yeah, no, it wasn't resistant to me. But yeah, as I said, I put that through an extreme amount of force to do that, which I was pretty much going like this to snap it, and you know, not trying to say that I'm anything special, but I'm pretty damn strong, and that is what caused it and gave it out to snap. And you know, on the inside I pushed it in like that on the barrier between the battery and the actual squonk bottle, and that did cause it to snap on the inside. But once again, that was a massive amount of force. So I'm actually pretty proud of that design. No, not He-Man. No, definitely not. But just as a scale of how much pressure would have been put on it, my grip has been tested to about 89 kilograms. Just in my hand. So both of those pushing on there would have been ridiculous. So yeah, so that's actually done its job. I'm going to be printing them off as a sellable item from the 2nd of September, But unfortunately, as with most little things like this, I'm only coming out with three of them. I'm still working on the other variant, which is a ClickFet mod, which I'm still finalizing and doing the final designs for those. But yeah, there's only going to be three mechanical squonkers to begin with. And three ClickFet ones. And that's just to begin with, to sort of, yeah, which shamelessly I'm saying is to bring up some more bank so I can make some more. By that stage I would have had the 3D printer set up properly. Yeah, they do. It does take time, but yeah, the three mechanicals will be probably ready by, just trying to think, what will be probably around, just trying to think. Probably the 18th of September. Nah, I probably won't do a reg myself, a regulated one. But the ClickFet one has got precautions and protections in it. No, not mech. The ClickFet one is sort of a FET driven thing, so you still sort of need to know how to, you know, safe ohm ranges on coils. But yeah, it'll be a bit more forgiving because it's got safety features. It's got reverse polarity, over or under voltage for the battery. What else did it have? Oh, it's got five click on, five click off. What else? Where did it have? Well, yeah. Yeah, it's got over voltage, under voltage, battery safety stuff, and yeah, various bits and pieces like that. So yeah, so there will be another one that's sort of a middle ground, but I'm not doing like a general regulated sort of stuff. Keep your ears out with Kendi if you're looking for regulated. Yes, that's exactly it, Pam. It does save your battery from full drain. It does give you a sort of a blink code on an LED to tell you that your battery's too low and it won't allow it to fire. But once again, that other one is also a squonker. But yeah. But anyway, guys, I'm gonna have to get moving because I've got to get ready for work. The other one will be a bit more forgiving, but yeah, you will still have to be able to put your coils in, do coils and stuff like that on you know, a rebuildable. But it, out of the two options, it'll be the safer. But yeah, but that one still hasn't been completely finished in the design process. I've printed one off. I've had a look at it, and there's a lot of stuff that needs to be improved on that one, because I've got to work within the confines of 3D printing stuff. Yeah, ohms, yeah, that's for sure. But it, as I said, it's a lot safer. You're limited to the site, the amount of amp draw on it. It'll shut down if the ohms are too low, or the voltage of the battery's too low. It'll warn you of that. It'll warn you if your battery's flattening. Yeah, it's got the whole click on, click off option. But yeah, but that's that one. But anyway, guys, I'm going to have to get going. Thank you very much for joining the show. I do appreciate it. Appreciate it a tremendous amount. I will catch you guys with Kenty next week. So thank you very much for joining and checking it out. Cheers, guys. See ya.
Makes me sad. It's even the worst good. There's a more good than bad. But our overlord's love to focus the blame, giving a bogeyman.